In this video, we will learn about properties of fluids, and this is second part of properties of fluids theory. So let's start. First, we will learn about viscosity. After that, we will learn about kinematic viscosity, and then we will learn about Newton's law of viscosity. Then we will learn about variation of viscosity with temperature, and then we will learn about types of fluids. So first topic is viscosity, and the diagram is in front of you. This shows the velocity variation near a solid boundary, and we show velocity in x direction, and in y direction we are showing the distance between the two layers, that is layer 1 and layer 2. This is our layer 1 and this is our layer 2. Layer 1 is moving with the velocity u plus du. Layer 2 is moving with the velocity du. Du is the difference of velocities, and dy is our change in distance between the two layers. Suppose this is our layer 1 and this is our layer 2. So layer 1 while moving applies some resistance to the layer 1, and layer 2 also causes some resistance to its adjacent layer. So this resistance between the adjacent layer of fluid is known as viscosity. So we can denote this quantity mathematically, but before that we also have to understand why the shear stress occurs between these layers. Suppose this is our layer 1 and this is our layer 2. So while moving there exists viscosity, and also due to relative motion between the two fluids and due to viscosity, a shear stress occurs between the fluid, and this is proportional to the rate of shear strain. So we write mathematically tau is directly proportional to du by dy. So tau is our shear stress and du by dy is our rate of shear strain, or we say it velocity gradient. So we write tau is equal to mu du by dy. So mu is our coefficient of dynamic viscosity, or simply viscosity. And we can rewrite mu as tau divided by du by dy. So here we can redefine viscosity as ratio of shear stress to the unit shear strain. So let's understand the formula clearly. So tau is equal to mu du divided by dy. Tau is our stress, that is shear stress. Mu is our coefficient of dynamic viscosity, and du by dy is our rate of shear strain, and this quantity is also known as velocity gradient. Now we will learn about units of viscosity. We know that viscosity is written as tau divided by du by dy, and tau is our shear stress, du is our change of velocity, dy is our change of distance. So we write dimension of shear stress as force divided by area, and dimension of velocity as length divided by time, and dimension of distance as length. So when we solve this, we get force multiplied by time divided by square of length. So now we can put the unit in this expression, and we will get units in SI and MKS. So in SI unit, the unit of force is Newton, for time it is second, and for length it is meter. So we get unit in SI as Newton second per meter square. When we talk about MKS, then unit of force is kgf, that is kg force, and for time it is second, and for length it is meter, so we get kgf second per meter square. When we talk about cgs unit, then we define unit of force as dyne, for time second, and for length meter, so we get dyne second per meter square. So generally you will find poise as a unit of viscosity. So this dyne second per meter square is also known as poise. So in cgs we define viscosity as poise. So for solving numerical problem, you can remember this relation, that is one poise is equal to 0.1 Newton second per meter square. Now we will talk about kinematic viscosity. So when we say simply viscosity, then it means dynamic viscosity. And for specifying kinematic viscosity, we have to specify the whole word kinematic viscosity. So kinematic viscosity is the ratio between dynamic viscosity and density of fluid. So we denote this by a Greek symbol called nu. And mathematically we write kinematic viscosity as ratio of viscosity divided by density, and we know dynamic viscosity is mu and density is rho. So we write this as expression mu divided by rho. Now we will talk about units of kinematic viscosity. So we know that we can find the unit of kinematic viscosity by dividing units of mu, that is dynamic viscosity, with unit of density, that is rho. So we know that in terms of dimension, we write the unit of dynamic viscosity as force multiplied by time divided by length square, and dimension of density is mass divided by cube of length. So while solving this, we get स्क्वायर ऑफ लेंथ डिवाइड बाय टाइम. नाउ वी कैन पुट द यूनिट एंड इन एमकेएस एंड एसआई यूनिट वी विल गेट मीटर स्क्वायर पर सेकेंड एज यूनिट एंड इन सीजीएस वी नो यूनिट ऑफ लेंथ इज सेंटीमीटर सो वी विल गेट सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर पर सेकेंड एंड दिस सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर पर सेकेंड इज नोन एज वन स्ट्रोक. सो दिस इज वट यू विल गेट इन न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम. यू विल गेट स्ट्रोक्स एज अ यूनिट. So we can convert this to SI as 1 stroke is equal to 10 to the power minus 4 meter square per second. And 1 centistroke is written as 1 divided by 100 stroke, or we can write it as 0.01 stroke. Now we will talk about Newton's law of viscosity. So shear stress on a fluid element layer is directly proportional to rate of shear strain, which we found in the viscosity. So here we write tau is equal to mu du by dy. So this is the expression for Newton's law of viscosity. So the fluid that obeys this relation are known as Newtonian fluid, and the fluids that do not obey this relation are known as non-Newtonian fluid. Now we will see the variation of viscosity with temperature. That means how viscosity is changing when we are increasing the temperature and when we are decreasing the temperature. First we will talk for liquids, and for liquids, the viscosity decreases when we increase the temperature. So why this happens? When we talk about fluids, then fluids means something that flows, that is liquids and gases. So for fluids, generally what happens, the viscous forces are due to two things. First thing is our cohesive force, and second thing is our molecular momentum transfer. Due to molecular momentum transfer, these viscous forces exist in fluids. So in the molecules are very closely packed, and due to this closely packed molecules, the viscous forces are dependent on cohesive forces here. So when we heat the fluid, that is liquid, when we heat the liquid, then these particles will separate from each other, and due to this separation the cohesive force will decrease, and if the cohesive force will decrease, the viscosity will also decrease. But when we talk about gases, then the viscosity increases when we increase the temperature. So this is because when we talk about gases, the particles are very far away from each other. So cohesive force do not play the main role here. So in gases, molecular momentum transfer plays major role. So when we heat the gas, then the molecular momentum transfer increases. So due to this, the viscosity of gas increases when we increase the temperature. So we can define this mathematically. For liquids, we write mu is equal to mu naught multiplied by 1 divided by 1 plus alpha t plus beta t square. So from here also you can observe that this viscosity is inversely proportional to the temperature. So as we are increasing the temperature, the viscosity is decreasing in case of liquids. So here mu is our viscosity of liquid at T degrees Celsius in Poise, and mu naught is our viscosity of liquid at 0 degrees Celsius in Poise, and alpha and beta are constant for liquid, and it is different for different liquids. Let's talk about expression for gases. When we talk about gases, we write mu is equal to mu naught plus alpha t minus beta t square. So here you can observe that the viscosity is directly proportional to temperature. So as we are increasing the temperature, the viscosity of gas is increasing. So here the value of mu, that is the meaning of mu, is viscosity of gas at T degree Celsius, and mu naught is viscosity of gas at 0 degree Celsius, and alpha and beta are constant for gases. Now we will talk about types of fluids, but before that we have to see how we plot this in a diagram. So the diagram is between shear stress and the velocity gradient, and this top point is for ideal solid. So this is how we show ideal solid, and the second line is our ideal plastic fluid. Third, this curved line is for non-Newtonian fluid, and this straight linear line is for Newtonian fluid. As we know that for Newtonian fluid, shear stress is directly proportional to velocity gradient, so the straight line is there for Newtonian fluid, and this is our ideal fluid. So when we talk about ideal fluid, we say these fluids are incompressible, they are having no viscosity. Generally, it is ideal fluid, it is not real fluid. So this does not happen in reality. So this is for ideal cases, that they are incompressible and they are having no viscosity. But when we talk about real fluid, then real fluids have viscosity, that is, they have resistance between their layers, and they also have finite compressibility. It means they can be compressed a little, water can be compressed a little, gas can be compressed much. So this is the case for real fluids. Now, next type is Newtonian fluid. So Newtonian fluids are those fluids where this relation holds, that is, shear stress is directly proportional to rate of shear strain. And when we talk about next, that is non-Newtonian fluid, then we say shear stress is not proportional to du by dy, that is, shear stress is not proportional to velocity gradient. So next type of fluid is our ideal plastic fluid. And when we talk about ideal plastic fluid, then we say shear stress is more than the yield value, and also tau, that is our shear stress, is directly proportional to shear strain.